Welcome to my chambers. There was a time in American history when the Congress wrote the laws and the president enforced the laws and the courts interpreted them. That's built into the Constitution, and we call it the separation of powers. The president can't write the laws, the Congress can't put somebody on trial, and the courts can't determine tax rates. That is at least the theory of the Constitution. But a disturbing trend, and it's not a recent trend, it goes back to Woodrow Wilson, keeps accumulating more and more power in the office of the president, not by legislation, but by Congress falling asleep while presidents take their power. And President Trump did this three times in the past week. It's a very dangerous trend when the president can make his own laws or spend money how he wants, even when Congress says no after he asked for it. So earlier this week, the president of the United States directed Patrick Shanahan, the acting Secretary of Defense, not to purchase a missile defense system that Congress had authorized and directed him to purchase. And at the time of that authorization, President Trump agreed with it, but to take that money from the missile defense system and use it to build a fence at the Texas-Mexico border. The border is 1,954 miles long. They want to build a 50-mile fence. You can question the wisdom of the fence. We know the president's in favor of it. But he asked the Congress for the money, and the Congress said no, and he took the money anyway. That violates the separation of powers. He also directed the Secretary of Defense to send troops to secure the border. That violates the separation of powers as well. Why? It's one of the laws the president swore to uphold when he took the presidential oath 2.5 years ago. Says that the military cannot be used for domestic law enforcement. This week, the president raised taxes. Raised taxes? Sure he did. He imposed a 25% tariff on all goods coming from China into the United States. Don't worry, the Chinese government will pay for it. Well, that's wrong. Yes, the goods are stopped at the border, and yes, the seller of those goods pays the tariff right then and there. And then the goods enter the marketplace here with a 25% markup on them. So this is effectively a national federal sales tax imposed by the president and not by the Congress. It is dangerous when presidents write their own laws, impose their own taxes, spend money how they want, and Congress looks the other way. It's dangerous because it's too much of an accumulation of power in the presidency, and it imbalances that delicate balance that the separation of powers created. We need to be careful about too much power in the hands of too few. Welcome to my chambers. Fight the good fight. Fight!